A French police officer is now facing a preliminary charge of voluntary homicide after allegedly shooting and killing a 17-year-old delivery driver. There's video that was caught on cell phone camera. It shows the moment that this incident occurred. Police say the shooting happened after the teen refused to comply with an order during a traffic stop. This happened on Tuesday in a Paris suburb. Violent unrest then erupted all across France in response. Close to 200 people have already been arrested. Curfews are now in place to try and curb a third day of protest. Inez de la Quatara is joining us now from Paris with more. So first of all, Inez, can you tell us about this teenager, about this delivery driver? Who is he?
Hey, Kana, yeah, so this has to do with an officer-involved shooting, and you mentioned it there. This is a 17-year-old that we're talking about who was identified as Nael. They haven't released his last name, but his first name is Nael, and he was shot and killed at a traffic stop by police officers. There is video of the whole thing, and that has set off massive riots and protests across the country. So they started in the suburb of Nanterre, where this first happened. They then spread to other suburbs around Paris, and they've now spread to the entire country. So we're seeing nationwide violence, really. It's making for some really stunning images. So cars and schools are being set on fire. Over 100 buildings have been damaged. At least one bank was ransacked. I will say they're not all violent, so we are seeing some peaceful protests as well. So today, for instance, there was a big march organized in the suburb of Nanterre by Nael's family. His family members participated in that march. His mother was there. They are demanding justice for him. But those protests then turned violence. We did see protesters clashing with police, firing fireworks at police, and police firing back with tear gas. Those protests are ongoing, and riot police now at the scene. They are bracing for a long night ahead.
And as the French government is heightening security measures, so what is the latest there in France? What is the president saying?
Yeah, so the president very much taking this very seriously. He has called for emergency crisis meetings, meeting with some of his ministers. He has ramped up the amount of officers on the streets. So they are deploying now 40,000 police officers across France. That is a huge number when you consider that just yesterday they had 9,000 police officers across the country. In Paris, they are more than doubling the amount of police officers who will be on the ground. And they are really trying to restore order and calm. Ministers are also being fanned out across the country. To the different suburbs that have seen violence erupting. They are also calling for calm, trying to work with regional officials to try and restore order. And then as far as the police officer who was actually involved in this shooting, he is in custody. He was arrested. He remains in custody. And he has been indicted for voluntary homicide.
Okay, and you mentioned this 40,000 police officers being deployed, and I know they're trying to avoid yet a third day of protests, but how long is this expected to last? Any idea?
The concern is that this could go on for a while. We have seen other similar instances of officer-involved shootings and police brutality that have gone on for weeks, if not months in some cases. I think what's important to note here, part of the frustration is coming from the fact that these protesters, these rioters, do feel that a lot of this police brutality is racially motivated. But the problem with France is that there's no way to actually prove that, because the government here in France actually bans the collection of data that is related to ethnicity or race. So while these protesters, while minorities may feel that they are being racially targeted, there's no data to back it up. There are no facts to actually prove their point, and so nothing is then done about their complaints. And that is the frustration here. That is the anger that you're seeing play out on the streets, Kana.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MAYHEM TV family. Please like and share MAYHEM TV. We love you all. Please support MAYHEM TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.